Welcome to Echoes of the Damned.
Echoes of the Damned. Echoes of the Damned. Echoes of
the Damned. Welcome, dear listeners, to another chilling episode of Echoes of the Damned. Tonight, we journey to the heart of France, to a place where the past refuses to stay buried. This is the story of Château de Brissac, a castle steeped in history, tragedy, and haunted by the restless dead. Château de Brissac stands tall and imposing in the scenic Loire Valley, its seven stories looming like a watchful guardian over the centuries. Its origins date back to the 11th century, built by the Counts of Anjou as a formidable fortress meant to protect the region from invading forces. These were dangerous times, and the castle's thick walls and strategic positioning were vital to its survival. But Château de Brissac was not destined to remain a fortress. In the 15th century, it was transformed by a wealthy nobleman, Pierre de Brézé. He reconstructed the castle, turning it from a military stronghold into a luxurious residence, a place of grandeur befitting the aristocracy. Yet within its opulent halls, whispers of intrigue, passion, and treachery began to weave a darker narrative. Over the centuries, the castle bore witness to countless personal dramas and mysterious events. Marriages were often strategic alliances rather than unions of love, leading to secret affairs and hidden passions. In the shadowed corners of the chateau, these passions sometimes turned deadly, leaving a stain that even the passage of time could not erase. One such tale involves the notorious Green Lady. But before we delve into her chilling story, it's important to understand that Château de Brissac has been a stage for far more than just one tragedy. During the Hundred Years' War, the chateau was a strategic target. Blood was spilled on its grounds, and the castle's stones absorbed the anguish of countless soldiers who fought and died within its walls. It's believed that some of these soldiers still march through the corridors, bound to the castle by the violent end they met. Then came the French Revolution, a time of chaos and bloodshed. The castle, once a haven of nobility and splendor, became a refuge for those fleeing revolutionary forces. Yet even its towering spires could not protect them from the wrath of the revolution. Many were captured and executed on the castle grounds, their desperate cries for mercy lingering in the air long after their voices were silenced. The violent upheaval of these times left a mark on Château de Brissac, a legacy of unrest and sorrow. It was widely believed that those who met violent or unjust ends were doomed to wander as ghosts, seeking resolution or revenge. The castle, with its history of betrayal, war, and execution, became the perfect setting for such restless spirits to linger. But of all the spirits that haunt this castle, none are as infamous or as terrifying as the Green Lady. The tale begins with Charlotte de Brézé, the illegitimate daughter of King Charles VII and his mistress Agnès Sorel. Married off to Jacques de Brézé, Charlotte entered a union devoid of love, marked instead by distance and indifference. Jacques was a man consumed by his love for the hunt, a pursuit that left little room for his wife's affections. Lonely and yearning for passion, Charlotte found comfort in the arms of another man. But as is often the case with such forbidden affairs, the truth eventually came to light. On the night of May the 31st, 1477, Jacques returned from a hunt and was informed by a servant of his wife's infidelity. Consumed by rage, he stormed through the chateau, eventually finding the lovers together in an act of betrayal that would seal their fates. What happened next is a tale of blood and horror. In a fit of uncontrollable fury, Jacques slaughtered both Charlotte and her lover, their screams echoing through the castle halls. It is said that the violence of their deaths imprinted itself on the very fabric of the chateau, forever binding Charlotte's spirit to the castle. Since that fateful night, Charlotte de Brézé has walked the halls of the chateau as the Green Lady. Dressed in a flowing green gown, she is often seen in the tower room of the chapel, her presence accompanied by an overwhelming sense of sorrow and loss. But it is her face that is most haunting, her once beautiful features now marred by the holes where her eyes and nose should be, a ghastly reminder of the violence that took her life. The Green Lady's spirit does not rest. She mourns, she moans, her cries filling the chateau in the early hours of the morning. Visitors and residents alike have felt her presence, seen her ghostly figure standing at the foot of their beds, or heard her sorrowful wails as they traverse the castle's darkened halls. But Charlotte is not alone in her haunting. The castle holds many secrets and many spirits. The specters of soldiers who died in battle, of aristocrats who met their end during the revolution, all share these ancient halls. Their stories intertwine with the chateau's history, creating a tapestry of horror and tragedy that lures those who are brave or foolish enough to explore. Today, Château de Brissac stands as a testament to both its opulent past and its haunted present. The Dukes of Brissac, who reside there, have grown accustomed to their spectral companions. Yet the castle's history, its tales of betrayal, war, and death, continue to draw those seeking a brush with the supernatural. If you dare to visit, know that the castle is at its most eerie during the full moon. It is under this pale light that the spirits are said to walk more freely, the veil between worlds at its thinnest. The Green Lady, in particular, becomes almost tangible, her presence sending chills down the spine of those who cross her path. As you wander the castle's halls, with each creak of the floorboards and each shadow that flickers in the candlelight, you may feel her watching you, waiting. So, are you prepared to enter Château de Brissac? To walk where history and horror collide, where the living share their space with the lingering dead? If you venture into this realm of shadows and echoes, remember, some stories are not easily forgotten. They cling to you, haunt you, much like the spirits of Château de Brissac. Until next time, dear listeners, may the shadows spare your dreams, if they can.